I'm always a fan of The Simpsons. You know, the show that ran from 1989 to onward. I used to like it when I was 11. I'm 14 now, and I still like the show to this day. If you still don't know it, it is an American animated sitcom created by Matt Groening, and produced by the Fox Broadcasting Company. The main characters are a satire of a working-class family, consisting of Homer, Marge, Bart, Lisa and Maggie. The series satires many aspects of American culture, society, politics and history. It's broadcasted on Fox, and later on in 2013, also broadcasted on FXX. I watched The Simpsons every time it came on, and I never missed an episode of it. Ever. However, I saw a rather odd episode of the show. It scared me for 7 months. At school, my friends were talking about the future Simpsons, and I really didn't bother joining that chat until I heard the word, episode 890. I joined the chat even though I still didn't bother to. At 3:05 p.m., I was finally able to go home. On the way home, I found an abandoned CD that said, The Simpsons, 890, please destroy, MG. Bingo. I have found a lost episode. I never found a lost CD before, so this was a big find. I also noticed MG is the initials for Matt Groening, the creator of the show. And why did it say please destroy? I was kind of suspicious, but I picked it up from the ground. Oh, man, how I would want to take that back. At home, I noticed that my dad hated having unknown CDs in the house, so I put it on top of my video games for my PS4 on my bookshelf. The next day, Monday, my dad went out to bring dinner from McDonald's. This means that I had to babysit my younger brother Jason. When he left, I played FIFA 19 on my PS4 until my dad came in the house with my dinner. After dinner, I started to think about the CD. So I grabbed the CD, and popped it in my PS4. It showed a countdown, and the episode started. The theme started, and there was nothing odd, except that the logo for the show was in Spanish. I thought it was a joke or error made by the writers. The episode started with Homer watching a commercial for a gun store.
Joe's Guns. Protecting your rights. We have pistols, Molotov cocktails, sniper rifles, and especially flamethrowers. Hunt down animals. Take a gun test. Murder your sons and daughters. Wait, forget that part. So why not come on down to Joe's Guns today?
Murder your sons and daughters. Oh!
Homer said, rubbing his hands.
Time to get revenge!
Then it cut to Homer inside Joe's Guns. The only person there was a male store clerk with big hair and glasses. They had this conversation.
Hello, sir. What can I do for you today?
I'd like a flamethrower.
A flamethrower? What are you gonna do with it? Burn that old warehouse that no one goes to anymore.
No, something else. I'm going to murder all of my sons and daughters.
You're joking, right?
No, the owner said it on the commercial.
He was only kidding around. I can't give you a flamethrower for that reason.
I said, give me the freaking flamethrower!
Homer didn't sound like himself here. His voice sounded really deep and distorted. Quickly, Homer got out a chainsaw and ripped off the clerk's head with it. Hyperrealistic blood splattered all over the screen. A later time card showed up, and then it showed Homer outside the house. He pulled the trigger, and fire blew out of it. Marge, Maggie, Lisa and Bart were swallowed up by it. At this point, the animation changed to a similar style to that of South Park. Inside the flames, Marge, Maggie, Lisa and Bart melted into crackling molten pizza with bones and blood. Then, Homer turned to the viewer.
I have killed all of them. Looks like I just chose another victim. And it's you.
Suddenly, the screen went to black. This is where it got more scary. A recent photo of me, my dad, and Jason was shown, except all of us were skeletons, and the screen flashed 666. How did this CD know me and my whole family? I pressed the power button but it wouldn't work. I unplugged everything, but it wouldn't work. I took the CD out but it wouldn't work. I tried to turn off my PS4, but it still wouldn't work. A satanic voice said,
you're now in my world. You cannot escape. There's no way out, James.
How did this CD know my name also? Maybe it's possessed? More pictures showed. Monsters from my dreams I haven't told anyone about, myself at the age of 7 dead, my younger brothers, or at least someone that looked really familiar to him, brains splattered, tragedies that did not happen yet, you get the point. Finally, a news report showed. It said 31 people died by an unknown cause after watching The Simpsons. After that, a demented message popped up. This is all your fault. Another message. You, whoever's watching this, will be dead very soon. Very, very soon. You'll die slowly, and painfully. I'll destroy everyone, with a little help from Satan. Then, the TV turned itself off. I was scarred and doomed, and got out my dad's phone. I called the cops, and they arrived just in time to see what the hell was going on. As soon as they arrived, the CD had one more thing to show, but the TV wasn't off yet. It showed a kid, no older than 13, in an abandoned house drinking a 2-liter bottle of soda for some weird reason. That's when the CD ended, but abruptly, with the TV finally turning itself off. When I was about to take the CD out of the PS4, it fell on the floor, scratched. I explained to the cops everything about the episode. Jason woke up to see what the fudge was going on. I explained everything about the situation, and he believed me. I showed them and my brother the entire CD, and they were all shocked at what has happened. Jason tried to smash the CD by tearing it apart, but it was indestructible. The next morning, Tuesday, I woke up early, like at 7:04. I had no choice but to get in contact with Dan Castellaneta, Homer's voice actor. I talked to him on Skype, and asked him questions like, why was one scene in another language, and, who made the episode? What inspired you to make it? He said that a serial killer named John Prolosky made this episode, if you and I were wondering. When I asked him how the episode knows my name, I heard a scream of pain. Then a very chilling voice said,
I got him, and now I'm coming to get you.
I hung up, and told everyone, we need to leave and pack our stuff, right now. I told my dad about what happened, but he didn't believe me. So it was just my brother and me. We rented a room at Red Roof Plus for the next few days. On Tuesday, I read a newspaper article titled, Serial Killer Carrying Flamethrower Got Shot by the Police. The killer was actually John Prolosky. Me and my brother celebrated with soda and pizza, and went back home.